Hi guys, welcome to a new video. Today I'm going to show you how we can make procedural terrain generation in Unity. First of all, let's create a plane and we want to delete the mesh collider because we only need a mesh renderer and a mesh filter. And then let's also add our script and call it terrain generation. And let's start by adding our variables. So we will need two floats or two integers. One is for the width and one is for the height. After that, we need a renderer. We also need some colors. So let's make an array. And we need a texture 2D. We can call it noise texture. And now let's come to our start function and we can add the code here. So first of all, we want to set the renderer. So we are going to get component renderer. After that, we want to set our noise texture. So noise texture is a new texture 2D, and here we can set the pixel width and pixel height, and let's make sure that the filter mode is point. So noise texture filter mode point. Now we can set the size of our array. So this is going to be 1 pixel width times pixel height. And we want to set our main texture to the noise texture. Now we can continue by setting our height map. So we will need a two-dimensional array. It's going to be float. And we can call it height map. And after we have done this, we can call a function with the name setHeightMap. And let's just make the function here. Public void setHeightMap, and first of all we want to set the size. So heightMap is equal to a new float. The first dimension is going to be pix width plus 1, second dimension pix height plus 1. And now we want to set a value for every point we have in our height map. So for this we need two for loops. Let's redo this. So the variable is going to be y and make this less or equal to pix height. And let's make another one with the pix width. And the variable is going to be x. And we can also have another float here. That's going to be our scale. Let's make one here. And first of all, we can get the x coordinate. This is going to be x as float. And divide this by our scale. And let's do the same with the y coordination. So float y divided by scale. And now we can use Perlin noise. So let's make a new float. This is going to be add f, Berlin noise, and then we are going to give the x coordinate and the y coordinate. And after that we can set our height map to the sample. Now we want to make a texture based on our height map, so we can make a new function and call it createTexture. And let's add the function here. So for this, we will need some different colors for different height values. So let's go to the top and make an abstract. So it's going to be system.serializable, public struct, and we can call it height color variable. And we need to write color usage through true to set this in the inspector. And let's make public color and call it height color. And we will also need a float. There's a problem here. I just autofilled to height color bar. Public float, and let's call it height value. And we want to have multiple of those, so let's come back here and make public height color variables as an array, and let's call it height color data. For the texture, we can copy this for loop and paste it. And this time, so we forgot to put the equal sign here. So here we don't want the equal signs, and let's just delete this and make another for loop. So this is going to loop to our height color data, and if our height map with the index x and y is smaller or equal to our height color data at that index, and the height value, we want to set the color. So here we can write pixel x times x height plus y is going to be equal to height color data dot I and the color value, and we can break the loop here and let's apply the texture. So noise texture and set pixels. We want to set our colors here and then apply it. Last, we want to make the mesh, so come back here to the start and let's make another function and call it create mesh. Let's add this function here, public void create mesh, and we can make the variables we need. So first of all, we need a height multiplier. That's going to be a float. Then we need some vector trees, and they are going to be our vertices. So the vertices of the mesh. And we also need some triangles and we need some UVs as well. These are going to be vector 2. And now we can just make the size of the arrays. So the words are going to be new vector 3. And the size is pixel width plus 1 times pixel height plus 1. So let's add and the UVs are the same, so just copy this and paste it and replace this with UV. And then we can make the triangles. We also need to do, so we need to change this to vector 2. And the last one is going to be pixel width times pixel height times 6. Now we can start by adding the vertices. So let's go back to our setHeightMap function and copy this loop and paste it here and just delete this one. So we want to add our vertices here, and the index is going to be y times x width and then plus x plus y. And this is going to be a new vector 3. So the position is going to be at x and our height map at that point. So x and y. And the z position is y. And we can also set the UVs here. So let's do the same thing. Plus y. And we forgot a plus here. This is going to equal to a new vector 2, and here we can get the y value as a float and divide this by our pixel height and do the same with the x value as a float and divide by pixel width, and let's just make this float as well. And let's continue by making the triangles. So let's paste the same loop again. And here we want to delete these equal signs. And let's start making the triangles. So for every vertices, we want to have 6 triangles. So I will start by thrice and put this y times pix width plus x times 6. And before we assign a value to this, let's just copy this and paste this 6 times. So this is 5 and this is 6. And let's delete these gaps here as well. And after that, let's up the index by 1. For every new triangle, so plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, and so on. This is plus 4, and this is plus 5. And we can start assigning the values here. So every value is going to start with y times x width plus x plus y. So we can just copy this and paste it. The first one is going to stay like that. The second one is going to have plus pix width plus 1. For the next one, we will add one more to this. And here again plus 1. Here we will add pix width plus 1. And at last we will add x width plus 2. And now let's make the mesh using these values. So first of all, we can get the mesh. Let's write mesh and then give it a name. we will get the component mesh filter. Get the mesh, and we can clear the mesh so that it's empty. And after that, we can make the vertices and the UV as well. Or let's do the triangles next. Then the UVs, and we will recalculate normals. Now we can go back to our project. We have some errors in the code, so before we go back to our project, we can go back to set height map and add float here, and for the y coordinates as well. And let's see, we have an error here. Instead of, so just replace them, and this should be it. Now we can assign these values here. So first of all, let's make the pix width and pix height, and select the scale and also a height multiplier. We will not assign these values here, so verts, tries, UVs, noise texture and so on. So you could also make these private, and we want to have some height color data. For example, let's make 5, and we can start with 0.4, let's say. This can be a blue color, or like seas and so on. So this is going to be the sea, and then we can have some sand like this, and let's make it 0.45. The next color can be green for grass, for example. And let's make it 0.7, and then we can make something like mountains. Let's make this 0.8, and then something more dark at 0.85. Now we have set all the values, and let's start the game. And we can see we have our map here, but it looks like the height multiplier is not big enough. I think we forgot to take the height map into consideration. Height multiplier. So let's add that here. Now we can see the height is also working. So the darker areas are like a bit more high, and the blue areas are lower. So that's it for the video. I hope you learned how to do procedural terrain generation, and see you in the next video for the next part.